Hello everyone, Dr. Callinan here. I just received an organic acids profile back from a patient, and I wanted to take this time to review the results with you and give you a bit of an idea about what we do here at the Wildside Wellness. This organic acid came from a 33-year-old patient, and she presented with fatigue, resistant weight loss, and anxiety type symptoms. And the profile is very similar to what I see with a lot of my patients. So this is organic acid testing that we have done. This looks at how you're processing your fatty acids through the beta oxidation cycle, essentially just how you're processing your fats for fuel. It looks how your carbohydrates are going through glycolysis. It looks at gut dysbiosis. And this is a urine test that measures different metabolic breakdown products in the urine. It can also give us an idea about what is going on with neurotransmitters without having to do a brain biopsy, which obviously would not be appropriate to do when dealing with something like anxiety and depression. So I'm going to share my screen and we're going to go through this lab together. This will give you an idea of what the organic acid test can measure and how we go about treating conditions like this at the Wildside Wellness. So I'm going to share my screen. Here we go. So to preserve patient identity, the names have been blocked off on this lab and no identification markers will be shown on this video. This is for educational purposes only and not intended to diagnose or treat any condition. Please speak with your practitioner, functional medicine doctor, naturopath before treating yourself or starting any new herbal or supplement support. That is the caveat and the blind statement recommendation for you so that we are all complying with regulatory standards. So here we go. This is the first page of your organic acids report. And this essentially looks at a summary of abnormal findings. So we have to take in consideration lab ranges as well as functional ranges. So lab ranges are very broad. They encompass 95% of the population. And unfortunately, a lot of conventional medicine doctors are only looking at lab ranges. Now, in order to get outside of lab ranges, your condition has to be pretty severe and it has to be chronic. So what I do is I look at functional ranges. What are the ranges that you need in order to function optimally? And those are much narrower. But we do see some abnormal findings which are dictating outside of lab reference ranges for this patient, as well as things through carbohydrate metabolism and vitamin B markers. So this suggests that she is outside of that 95% range and she does require a need for B vitamins, which we're going to dive deeper in as this report goes, as well as ways to support elevated lactate levels in the body. And there's some suggestions here of bacterial dysbiosis because D-lactate is elevated, which is just a general marker for dysbiosis overall. So let's dive in a little bit deeper so that we can have a look at the nitty-gritty and those functional reference ranges. So moving on to page 2, we are looking at fatty acid metabolism. So this looks at how efficient beta oxidation is running. So essentially what happens is either the stored fat or the fats that you consume for fuel needs to be brought into your mitochondria to be burned for energy. So we are seeing here that she has a high normal here on number 2, and this could suggest a need for both carnitine and B2. Carnitine and B2 are amazing nutrients to help with weight loss plateaus, and this is really making sure that those fats you are eating and the fats on your body are efficiently being converted to energy through beta oxidation. So the very first thing to consider in a case with resistant weight loss with high normal on number 2, sabutyrate, I would recommend looking at things like carnitine and B2. When we move further down these labs, we will know that a similar trend is going on with these need for B vitamins. So the need for B2, the need for B vitamins as we go on is going to come up and come up and come up again. So my recommendation for this patient is to start with Bs, and then we'll see if we need to add carnitine in at the end. Her carbohydrate metabolism, so this is glycolysis. This is how efficiently you're burning carbohydrates for fuel. And we see here, again, this trend of this elevated L-lactate is we need B vitamins as well as alpha-lipoic acid to process carbohydrates for fuel. L-lactate can also be elevated if you're doing a lot of anaerobic exercise, producing that lactic acid in your muscles 1 to 2 days prior to testing your organic acids. This was not the case for this patient. So what we also need to consider is L-lactate can be elevated in conditions with low oxygen status in the body. So we want to look at sleep apnea, asthma. Do we need to do some deep breathing? We need to assess here whether or not the body is getting adequate oxygenation. So one of the things that did come up in the patient history is shortness of breath as well as difficulty sleeping. So my recommendation to this patient would to be assessed for sleep apnea using a sleep study. Then what we can do is when we retest, we want to see that this L-lactate is coming within the normal ranges. Looking at energy production through the citric acid cycle, 7, 8 are, you know, high here, 9 is high normal borderline. And really we're looking at here is we want to support the citric acid cycle using B vitamins and magnesium, and glutathione and iron also play a role in the citric acid cycle. So this is your energy production. So we're thinking about things like a B vitamin, coenzyme Q10, which is an antioxidant, as well as amino acids to run the citric acid cycle. So instead of supplementing with amino acids, what we can do is we can make sure to include enough proteins in the diet and ensure that protein is being digested by eating in a relaxed state or considering some digestive enzymes. Magnesium is a cofactor for so many different reactions as you are seeing throughout this organic acid cycle. So oftentimes I'll recommend magnesium as a foundational supplement for patients because our soils are depleted in magnesium, then our plants become deficient and we're not getting adequate supplies in our diet. You can use magnesium cream. You can do 1 to 2 cups of Epsom salts in a warm bath to promote getting that magnesium through your skin, or you can supplement with magnesium. Magnesium citrate is the least absorbed form of magnesium. That's really only good if you want to have loose poops or you are constipated and you need a quick fix. Magnesium citrate is fine. What I like to do is I look for a magnesium bisglycinate that is much better absorbed, and that is what I use. For dosage of magnesium, I'm finding that practitioners are not dosing high enough. You really need about 5 times your body weight in pounds in milligrams of magnesium. So that typically looks like 300 to 700 milligrams of magnesium a day in divided dosages. So some throughout the day, some before bed. Magnesium is a really, really important cofactor, especially for hormone balance and resistant weight loss and energy and libido. So instead of supporting hormones, what we first need to do is build a strong foundation, a strong nutrient foundation, so we can see if the body will realign and rebalance on its own. Nutrient deficiencies, gut health, basic foundation is going to be much more important than simply Band-Aid solutions supporting hormones with, you know, progesterone cream or even Vitax, which will boost progesterone. Those are all great, but it's not going to replace your foundation if it's not there. So that's why I love organic acid, to see what nutrients you might be lacking in. So for this patient, magnesium, B vitamins, and CoQ10 may be helpful. Moving on to page 3, again, B complex markers. We're seeing 17 and 18, 19, high normal. These are suggesting more need for B vitamins. The one that's really interesting is number 19 here. This is a biotin-dependent pathway. So it's not very often that we see low biotin actually on organic acids test. The hair, skin, and nails industry has really pushed biotin, but biotin for hair, skin, and nails is really only helpful if you are deficient. And oftentimes, deficiencies are not really that common in biotin. But in this patient case, biotin here is showing deficient. So ensuring that she is taking a B complex with adequate biotin in its active form is going to be really important. Moving on to methylation cofactors, you know, her overall methylation support is good. There's not showing a high need for B12 and folate. And, you know, when women are looking to boost energy, they go to the health food store and they typically say, yes, I need B12 because B12 is for energy. And while that might be so in some patients, it's really important to look at it by a case-by-case basis and do some testing, because B12 here is probably not going to be that helpful. She would be much better off on a complete B complex, because we've seen that come up more and more. Moving on to neurotransmitters, 22 can actually be elevated in periods of stress. This is a marker of norepinephrine and epinephrine breakdown products. So the more stressed you are, the more catecholamines, norepinephrine, and epinephrine your body's going to produce. And this is just showing that there's a lot more of that breakdown products in the urine. So this is, you know, borderline coming up too high. So we want to look at stress support. What can we do from a mindset piece? Meditation, deep breathing would be really, really important. Remember on page one, we saw the need for extra oxygen. So just taking the time to do some meditation and deep breathing is going to be really helpful. It's not all about, you know, a supplement. We have to do the diet and we have to do the lifestyle. Those things are as equally as important for your overall health and continuing to maintain health and prevent disease in the future. We also see that picolinolate is elevated, number 27, you know, not in the range that it's reporting as outside those lab values, but this is something I do tend to look at because this is a tryptophan metabolite and we can see this elevated in inflammation. So inflammation is something that I'm always on the lookout for. How can we reduce inflammation by reducing stress? And another way that you can reduce inflammation is actually adding more omega-3s in your diet. So those healthy anti-inflammatory oils, olive oil, fish oil. For this patient, you might consider a fish oil supplementation if diet is not going to be adequate to promote these anti-inflammatory properties. You know, doing your greens, doing your dark leafy greens, your berries are all going to be really important for antioxidant support, or considering an omega-3 supplement. Oxidative damage. So we do not want oxidative damage in the body. 28 is a general marker for oxidative damage, whereas 29 is more specific for DNA damage. We do not want our DNA to be damaged because this will increase our risk for things like cancer. We are looking at borderline high for 29. So looking at some general antioxidant support would be helpful in this case. Increasing things like your dark berries is going to be really helpful. Healthy oils is going to be helpful. Or doing things like antioxidants, you know, your glutathione, your polyphenols, your vitamin C would be appropriate here. Looking over here at detoxification markers, number 30 is a marker of exposure to xylene. And this is an environmental toxin that we typically see in paints, varnishes, and other types of solvents. So you would want to note if you are exposed to elevated levels of xylene, where this is coming from. Are you painting? If you are painting, okay, it's showing up. How can we protect ourselves with masks? Making sure it's properly ventilated in there. If you have new carpets, are you allowing it to air out? Always looking at ways to promote environmental cleanliness within your home. Looking at using safe cleaning products, safe personal care products. Those things are always going to be also going to be appropriate here. 34 and 35 are also elevated. So we want to see, you know, sulfate can be elevated if you are consuming a lot of cruciferous vegetables, which is great. But if you're not and sulfate is elevated, we're thinking this is more of a need for phase two detoxification through that sulfur phase in detox. So this could be suggesting that you're utilizing your glutathione, which is your master antioxidant, more quickly, or there's more need for glutathione. And that really fits the picture better because I know from the clinical patient history that there is not a lot of sulfur containing foods in the diet. And because we're seeing that elevated levels of 30 and 34, we're probably thinking that there is an increased need here through phase two detoxification. So supporting phase two detox with, you know, glutathione or NAC, which is the precursor to glutathione, NAC, would probably be really helpful here. Moving down to bacterial dysbiosis, Indican is a general marker of dysbiosis. This is, you know, high, borderline high, as well as our D-lactate is higher. So D-lactate is a marker of lactobacillus or dysbiosis in general. So if this patient was taking a lactobacillus probiotic, that could be the reason that it was high. You know, if not, then we're looking at general dysbiosis and wanting to treat that as well. Her marker for candida was normal, so we're not concerned about candida in this patient. And candida was something that came up in the patient history, so I was glad to see this within normal range. So that is a really brief, really fast overview of what organic acids can tell you. And the thing that's really great is that we can come up with an individualized plan for you, whether that is compounding a unique supplement based off of your needs, or coming up with, you know, other products that are going to be specific for you. So again, for this patient, I'm looking at a B complex, I think would be really helpful, and alpha lipoic acid to help her process her foods for energy. That'll boost energy, that'll help with resistant weight loss. We're thinking NAC for that general detoxification. And then we are considering, if that doesn't help, CoQ10 in the future. That is a really great antioxidant, as well as carnitine. Carnitine and B2 to help process those fats for fuel. This is really, really good for weight loss plateaus. Okay, so that is essentially what I have come up with based off of this patient's clinical history and organic acid testing. I think organic acid testing once a year on each and every person would be amazing, so that you know what your nutrient levels are, how you're processing things, and where you are at. And then you can really customize a treatment protocol specifically for you. I'm going to add magnesium in here. And this is really foundational for this patient, antioxidant support. So it's all about individualized medicine, finding what works for you, and getting something customized. There is no point in you going to the health food store and just purchasing, you know, a multivitamin, because there could be a more specific plan for you. And the example I used over here was B12. You know, you're low in energy, you go, you get B12. Well, you actually probably didn't need B12. You were more in need of a B complex. And once you correct those nutritional markers, do the diet and lifestyle, you'll be well on your way to living your optimal life. And I truly believe that when you feel well, you can go on to do anything that you want to do and are meant to do. It's often not about a lack of time to do everything that you want, it's a lack of energy. So my focus is energy, resistant weight loss, hormone balance, and gut health. And then, you know, that all relates to your inner health as well as your outer health with your skin. So that's a little bit what I do at the Wild Tide Wellness, one of the testings that we do. I hope that was helpful.